say working with a director like Todd Haynes on I'm Not There, or perhaps it's his private version of Bob Dylan, he was incredibly visual. And so he compiled a folio of images of Dylan, but also the feeling of the era in which, you know, my particular Dylan existed. I could somehow see immediately the texture and the feeling and the world that I had to rise up to and inhabit. And someone like Scorsese, when I in Diego, played Hepburn, the direction he gave me what was the rehearsal process was that I wanted to look anything like her. I could be blonde if I wanted to. And in the end, I think once I'd finished, I realised that what he was doing was liberating me from feeling that I had to do or be or looking like it. He did that wasn't what he was interested in. And so he screened Hepburn's scribble comedies, which had a pace and delivery and energy. I mean, of course, scribble comedies. He wanted feeling and energy in the performance. And so he, I think a good director in a way throws those things out for actors to pick up if it's useful. In a way, when one gets offered a role like Bob Dylan, as a woman, you're liberated from the get-go in terms of imitation. So even if I tried to imitate Bob Dylan, I couldn't. And in the end, it's not the work, it's not the job, you're not making a documentary about your fiction. And strangely enough, if the internal work isn't going on, and doesn't lift off, if there's not some sort of connection either intellectually or spiritually or however you would describe it. If the internal work's not fine, then the character would go off to the
rest. Gene and Jones, lots of genetics. I remember you.
Just like the last time you had my insists on us.
Who immediately picks up on whether somebody is self-conscious? And the main transformation of life as the character moves from the age of 6 to 86. In that particular instance, I thought, well, I don't know who I grew up with. And watching her age, so I drew on that a lot. But in the end, when you're performing the scene, you have to lose the conscious relationship to those physical gestures. Otherwise, I think what the audience sees, particularly in a close-up or even in a mid-shot, is that all they register is the work. Some stage would definitely not film if you don't want people to see. You always have to have a sense of levitation as an actor.